Hello, hello! Perfidious Pete here, back for the sloppiest wreck since Mel Gibson and Lindsay Lohan decided to carpool home from the bar in XCOM 2. And last mission, man, what a mess. Not since Genghis and Ogadai died and let the Empire fall apart has there been a bigger Mongolian cluster. Just bad decision-making, poor strategy, some salt-inducing high percentage whiffs. It was basically a porno starring Cartman's mom, just an absolute shit show from top to bottom, beginning to end, front to back. Man, it was bad. Now, a clever person would use last mission like that as an opportunity to review their tactics, adjust their strategy, and then try to do better in the future. Unfortunately, I'm not that clever, so instead, I'm just gonna keep barreling forward on my momentum like a runaway train and hope that I've got enough steam built up at this point to carry me on through to the end. I mean, that's the lesson that today's society sort of teaches us. You don't need to learn from your failures or adjust course if you just keep on moving. How many careers have adopted that particular motto? You know, like Donald Trump, got your Uwe Boll, Jean-Claude Van Damme, the entire Kardashian family, and of course, who could forget the epitomic example, the Wachowskis. So I say what we do is we just head on up to the old bridge here, get to scanning, and see if I can't keep milking the bottled lightning of my mobile infantry just long enough to squeak out a Jupiter Ascending of my very own. Do we need supplies? Not really. We're sort of okay for, we could always use supplies. What are our other options, though? Well, we could either do supplies, we could go to the back market. Weren't we working on making contact? You know what? I would rather finish making contact over here with the Eastern United States more than I would rather get those supplies. We can always circle back for the supplies. We're like the outlaw Josie Wales. We can circle back. It's fine. I would like to finish this sometime this year, though. AP rounds. Hand machine from ultra-strong, ultra-light alien alloys. Deadly rounds will effectively bypass all enemy armor to deal unmitigated damage. Okay, well, that seems amazingly good. Why have I not been doing more experimental ammo? That's just real good. Ignores armor. That's very strong. Is it better than blue screen rounds, though? I mean, ignoring armor is nice, but now that I think about it, maybe blue screen rounds is actually better. Blue screen rounds ignores armor on robots and does additional damage. But as it stands, we have people still waiting for an assignment. Yeah, well, find them something to do then, Lily. Delegate, girl. This is your job. Or staffing a facility. Except every facility is staffed and everything that's being built is already being built. I don't know what you want me to do. Another powered weapon. Let's try some more. Let's do another experimental ammo.
Interesting choice. I'll send word as soon as we're finished, Commander.
I don't know why you say it's particularly interesting. The AP ammo is intriguing. AP ammo would actually be better for Jake Busey than what we've been giving him lately. He doesn't really need blue screen rounds. It seems like those are more of a dizzy sort of thing, but the AP ammo for Jake Busey could be really good. He does enough damage that just ignoring something's armor, by and large, is going to be sufficient to let him get the kill. We're gonna have to try that out. Alright, back to scanning. Now let's get this contact finished. Gatekeeper autopsy is gonna finish very soon.
Will likely prove crucial to our ongoing efforts.
Well, if it does what I think it does, Tygen, I'm gonna have to agree with you on this one, because I'm thinking this is gonna unlock the alien Psyamp. Hell yeah.
Unusual appearance is somehow directly
connected. We're gonna go build one of those pretty much immediately too. Aptitude.
The aliens always have some reasoning to their actions.
Really? They don't just ever get like a feat of pick and run a pick of... A feat of pick? What the hell was I trying to... A fit of pique is actually what I was trying to say, but my language skills are failing me here. I'm just gonna bail on this. God damn you, Dr. Tygen. How dare you, like, goad me into a performance error of that nature. Alien Psyamp. Yeah, we want to build one. So the only other thing we can research here is an alien data cache, which I don't give a single shit about. So let's go to the shadow chamber. Yes, I'm aware. No, I don't know. I don't want to do this. I want to go to the shadow chamber. Leave anyway? Yes. 5 days to the Avatar corpse? Well, we can do it now. All research projects will be suspended. We're not doing one!
This creature represents a near-perfect fusion.
Making
of
me
human
salty.
And
it gave me the pop-up
DNA
warning, at least, to let me know. I love that the time that I accidentally canceled the Gatekeeper project, they didn't tell me. Perhaps the time I don't have a project that I'm actually doing, whatever.
Still, this can lead me to only one logical conclusion.
It has boobs and you're thus ridiculously enthused because any bit-breasted alien is right into your wheelhouse, Dr. Tiger? Boobs are great. What's not to like? I mean, I'm on board. I understand you this time. Seems like an odd thing to leave as your ghost message.
We have found our avatar.
Yeah, it's Zoe Saldana. Alright, well, Dr. Tigan, he's a full James Cameron fan, what can we say? So no shadow projects available. This is fine. Reviewing our upgrade. Why do we want to go look at something we already did? What I want to do is go down to engineering and build an alien psyamp pretty much immediately. So that's technically a weapon? Yes. One gatekeeper shell, 200 supplies. We've got all this shit. This is fine. 200 supplies. It's expensive, but again, we've got supplies in spades right now. We can afford it. Well, that's really going to make Neil Patrick Harris a devastating force for our team. If we had had that last episode, I'd really like to see what we could have done with that gatekeeper. Looks like Casper Van Dien just recovered from his wound, so he's just back in action prior to us landing here in the eastern United States to let our friends know, hey, this is where the revolution truly started. I mean, it started in 1776, roughly, in this neighborhood, and now it's time. We're doing it again. Although, actually, our revolution started somewhere in, like, eastern China, so we're just expanding it to here, basically.
New regional contacts located.
So we could head down to Mexico, or we could go... Well, we already had the western U.S. because we started, like, in China, so we're good. Hidden reserves does what again? Plus 5 Avenger power? I mean, we sort of have more power than we need at the moment. Let's circle back and grab these supplies really quick.
Avenger plotting new course.
We did just burn a couldn't we? You know, wouldn't it have been shorter to go the other way? I don't want to question your piloting, Bradford. But I'm pretty sure flying this way is the long way around the planet when we're going to, you know what? It's fine. Whatever. Just keep drinking your gin, Bradford. Stay behind the wheel. New constructions. All right. So the dark event that they completed wasn't the hidden event. It's just the facility counter goes up by 2 weeks. I'm not troubled by that at all.
Located one of their facilities.
Aliens have completed construction of a secret facility. Let's view the facility. Fortunately, we're well poised to go just knock that shit right over. Operation Hellish Knight. That's an encouraging project name, Bradford. Yeah, that's delightful. So the aliens have picked up one pip towards the Avatar project. Can we just straight up go over there and wreck it? No, we do not have contact there, but we could make contact there. We might even have... Actually, I think we do have enough intel because we have a relay tower here, right? We do. All right, well, let's just grab these supplies and then we'll go kick over an alien facility, I suppose. Neil Patrick Harris has picked up Soul Steel, and the only ability left, I guess, is Sustain, so might as well do that. Keep training, Neil. What are we going to do with Neil Patrick Harris when his training is done? I mean, I suppose we could shove somebody else into the old training chamber, but Neil's never let us down. Do we really need him? Talon rounds. Wicked microshards of alien alloy and impact granting plus 20 critical chance and plus 1 bonus damage on critical hits. That's interesting, especially plus 20 critical chance if we put that on a shotgunner. Is that better than ignoring armor? I mean, it's going to make almost every shot a guaranteed critical for Jake. We may have to try both of those out and see which one is better. I think this is time to get... we're going to have to go like easy. You did in your college years. It's time but to get a little experimental. We're going to have to try some things out and see what's going
Agreed.
On.
Agreed. We must inform the commander immediately.
Go right ahead.
Commander?
I guess I'm here.
The Shadow
Thanks.
Chamber has completed its analysis of the Avatar's DNA.
I love that you guys were talking about me like I wasn't here when apparently I was here all along.
To travel through the psionic gate.
Perfect. Can finally shut this Avatar project down for good.
Yeah, Bradford's just
However,
drunk enough to think that traveling to an alien planet
than
is a
mere
good
transmission
idea.
Of genetic data.
The sequence has to be part of a live subject.
Okay.
The key only works in lockstep with the signal.
All right.
We don't have time to find another one of those things, let alone capture it.
No.
Let's make our own.
That part we can handle. We make our own.
Yeah, what a surprise.
Serious.
Quite. Though the specimen before us is damaged beyond repair, it has provided us with its complete genetic blueprint.
So the Dr. Tigan and Lily plan then is clearly we fucking fight fire with fire. We're gonna make an Avatar project of our own. No way could this possibly go wrong.
So, what's the catch?
Yes, that. Without an elder consciousness driving it, the new Avatar would remain as lifeless as the one before.
What a surprise. Our Frankenstein monster doctor can build a Frankenstein, but he cannot give it the spark of life like Victor Frankenstein.
But I can, in a way. by manipulating the new avatar via the psionic network.
So Lily is in charge of the lightning machinery that's going to reanimate our cobbled-together monstrosity.
Exactly. And definitely not me.
Interfacing directly with their network would cause severe, if not fatal, trauma to an unprepared central nervous system.
Could you guys get to the point already? What is it that you need me to do to make this ridiculous plan even theoretically possible? Kind of fantastic. Sure. No, it's fine. I'll do it.
The stasis suit created the perfect
You know, your significant glances fill me with trepidation.
One tailored to your specific biology, Commander. Of any human candidate, you are the most likely to survive the connection.
You know, it's a lot of pressure you guys are putting on me here.
Not good enough, Doctor.
It is the only answer I can give you, and our only option to traverse the alien portal.
Did we not?
We need to come up with a game plan before we charge through the enemy's front door.
All right, well, see, at least Bradford's showing a little sense.
Think about this, Commander.
So are we up to the final mission, then? Is that it?
This being is something else entirely. Something beyond anything we have ever seen. And yet somehow, our troops once again prevailed.
Yeah, we shot it with a lot of bullets, Dr. Tigan. I mean, it wasn't fucking rocket science. So I'm assuming then that we can just straight up go through the gate. Do we have anything else to do? No, facility. We have a facility lead and an alien. I mean, I guess we'll do this research.
I had assumed you'd make that research a priority, Commander. I'll notify you as soon as the report is available.
Can we just, is this it? Are we doing the final mission here? Can we just go assault the alien base?
Priority message to the commander coming through on a secure channel, sir.
Oh, wait a minute. What's this? Okay.
Sir, it's coming from the Advent Network Tower.
Oh, what is Advent one? Are we going to get to finally talk to fucking John Lennon?
You risk contacting us like this.
Oh, it's not John Lennon, it's fucking Optimus Prime. I wanted to make fun of the Thin Man, who's clearly a Thin Man.
Your efforts in rebuilding the Resistance Network and uncovering the truth about the Avatar Project have been admirable.
Yeah, once again, your fucking praise fills me with shame, Optimus Prime, as always.
Advent is not taking the death of an elder lightly, and in turn have greatly accelerated the final stages of their Avatar Project. A plan is now in place for the rapid processing of all non-essential human life.
Wouldn't that, according to the aliens, pretty much just be all human life? So the aliens are ramping up their Avatar Project, and they're gonna start chewing through the Soylent Green at a... That's fine, whatever. Advent burgers will be cheap, at least.
Human condition. Billions will flock to gene therapy clinics across the globe. They will never return.
You know, really, Optimus Prime? I mean, people, just as a group, by and large, are not particularly bright. Person can be smart, but people generally are kind of panicky idiots. But here's the thing also about the whole panicky idiot thing, Optimus Prime. Once a billion people start going, you know, it's not going to take a whole bunch of people to go to these clinics and disappear for the rest of the populace to catch on. I mean, if your family goes in and you're like, hey, we're going to the clinic to get cured, and you're like, all right, I'll see you tomorrow, and then they never come back, at some point you're going to be like, hey, you know, my family didn't come back. And I'm seeing a lot of stuff on Twitter and social media lately about people whose families have been disappearing. Maybe there's something going on with these clinics. It wouldn't take too terribly long, I think, before the world sort of caught on to the fact that going into a clinic means they disappear you forever.
Know what is happening here. Wake them up. Broadcast the truth before there is
yeah again Optimus Prime I don't really feel like this is so totally necessary.
It seems we are both out of time.
Please tell me Optimus Prime pulls a gun out and shoots himself in the head. Save the last bullet for yourself, Optimus Prime.
New objective.
Okay, well, the death of Optimus Prime has actually I don't want to say this because it sounds shameful, but it has filled me with glee. I hope he had to. I hope the way this plays out in my head, that Optimus Prime was in a bitter gun battle, and I mean, he seemed fairly capable. He probably took down a few Advent soldiers, but I have to hope that they just ultimately stormed his facility and overran him, and then at some point he was crouched behind that desk, one bullet left in the gun, and he's like, well, I always knew it would come down to this. Last one's for me. You know, it sounds awful, but a man can dream. A man can dream. I hate Optimus Prime with a passion. I hope that's the way that went down. Assault the Advent Tower Network, or Network Tower. So this, is this the final mission?
I've updated our objectives based on the latest findings.
Okay, which are where, by the way? Can we? Where's this mission at? We should be able to assault the network tower. Is this? This may be the final mission. Oh, never mind. Okay. Commander. Intel ops.
This is our chance to strike at Advent's heart. Once we control the network tower, we can finally show the world what the aliens are doing. There's no turning
back.
Wait,
what is this stuff here? Squad-wide individual concealment, which does every squad member will start the mission individually concealed. Interesting. That costs 41 intel. Squad blitz, everybody gets run and gun. Squad integrated combat. We don't have enough intel for any of this stuff, so I guess our intel options are going to be zero. There are only 9 enemies on this map. An Andromedon, a Codex, a Viper, and some Archons. Alright, well this, I mean Operation Bone Valley. Seems like the aliens are going to be the ones getting the boning. Alright, I guess we'll just do this. Operation Bone. I don't think we need any of this. This is a new mechanic to me. I don't totally understand it, but what we should be doing then is compiling and sort of scraping together as much intel as we can. Alright, well let's just, can we do this mission? Begin the final assault. No, then.
We won't have time to advance our research or deal with the wounded. We should only deploy once we're fully prepared.
Yeah, okay, all right, Bradford, that's fine. All right, so what I want to do then is I want to stock up on intel. We're going to need to spend some time stocking up on intel before we go do this. So we're in final mission phase then. I don't think there's any benefit. I mean, we already have armed to the teeth, so... Yeah, we're going to go back to Resistance HQ, and we're just going to start stocking up on intelligence.
Setting course for East Asia.
If we get a mission in between time, I'm okay with that, but I would kind of like to have every single possible advantage and ability going into the final mission. I would like to have all of those things. No, I don't want to spend any intel. I want to gain intel.
I do not think I could have predicted this outcome.
Yeah, I don't. That's fine. Intriguing. Here, give me, you know what, a data cache, actually. Yeah, that's fine. This gives us intel, so we should absolutely at least do this data research. So we're going to spend the next 5 days scanning for intel while we do that research and see how much that gets us. This should get us quite a little boost. We also have a supply drop coming in, but we don't really... Shit. Okay. What's the mission? Oh, it's... Okay, Optimus Prime is dead. Our monthly summaries, we don't have to listen to him anymore. We don't have to talk to that bastard ever, ever again. We've got the Avatar progress so beat down, we don't even really have to worry about it. This is the greatest monthly report of my life. I am absolutely enthused. Here's the question. Are we gonna assault the alien facility before any of these become a problem? There's no way we're gonna waste money on the hidden... Yeah, no, we're not gonna do it. That's fine, we're gonna ignore that. Again, supplies we don't really need. We're just gonna passively pass time, accumulate intel.
Defense facility now operational.
Yeah, too little, talk about too little too late. Let's just carry on. Sure. Go ahead and put an engineer on that. There you go, Frederick Hansen. It's your first day on the job. Or rather, you've been on the job for months, but we finally have something for you to actually do. And Neil Patrick Harris is now, like, fully trained, right? Yeah, there's nothing else for Neil to do. He's fucking teleported and he took Elsie with him. His powers are beyond measure. He's above level 9,000. Okay, well, it's good. Scilab done. All right. Back to scanning then. I want almost all of these intel abilities. We're gonna need like 120 roughly intel.
The results to be as intriguing as I do.
Just carry on. We're good. This might be it, then. We might be... how much do we need to get every bonus? How much are you? 40-something? 41? So what are we looking at there? 76. Ugh. We're going to need about... sorry. We need more. We don't have enough. No, cancel you. All right. Well, we'll just keep scanning. We're just going to keep building up intel. If we get a mission in the meantime, that's fine. We'll go fight the mission. And that's... All right. So we're going to have to do one more guerrilla op, then, before we can pull off the base assault. I'm okay with this. Counters a hidden dark event. No, don't care. Counters alien infiltrator. That I kind of dislike because it seems like fighting the tower with faceless on a map. Oh, never mind. You know what we're going to do? We're going to do whichever one of these has the most intel, and that one had 136. Very difficult, very difficult. So, yeah, we're going to be doing Operation Vengeful Death then. Not because we give a shit about any of the dark events. Likely our next mission is just going to be our assault on the network tower. This gives us 136 intel. That's going to be enough for us to go in with every single possible bonus.
Setting
Setting course for I'm actually really glad I waited. States. My, for once, procrastinating and dithering has paid off. Suck it, real world. You're always like, oh, don't put off until later what you can do today. Clearly not. If that what you could do today is assault the alien network tower, you put that shit off for as long as possible. Alright, so Jake Busey, we're gonna get rid of these Venom rounds. And we're instead, I think A ignores 5 points of armor. I think AP rounds are gonna be better for Jake Busey than the Talon rounds. The increased critical seems really tempting and very strong, but I think overall we're probably better off if we forego that. We could give Talon rounds to Amy Smart, but do we wanna leave? You know, actually I think what we'll do is get rid of these Dragonfire rounds for Amy Smart and go with Venom instead. Venom does more damage, and it's, we don't, I was going to say, setting people on fire with the incendiary rounds does prevent them from using advanced abilities, so it makes them handy for fighting like a codex or something, because being on fire does prevent them from doing that, but Amy Smart is usually shooting at robots or targets that have ridiculous health, and setting them on fire doesn't tend to be particularly useful. Debating internally here. What if we gave the dragon rounds to Seth Gilliam? Now, call me crazy, but there's a reason I'm doing this. I know saturation fire can set your square on fire. Sometimes it's a bug, but I also know that they claim to have fixed it in a recent patch. It's not supposed to start our square on fire anymore. This is our last chance to test this definitively, so we can make sure that at least once during this mission, one of our troopers uses saturation fire. And if that's the case, I think dragon fire rounds are a better choice for Gilliam. One mimic, but yeah, it's fine. We're good. Let's do this. Do we want the dizzy? I'm thinking about bringing the Kurgan on this mission for one very specific... Ah, you know what? No, it's fine. I was thinking about we don't want to get any of our premier troopers hurt. And it would sort of be a curtain call for Clancy Brown, sort of a last hurrah, but... My theory now is, what if we take Clancy Brown and he does slightly less than the amazing performances Dizzy has been pumping out lately and somebody gets hurt as a result of that, and then we're down somebody we really need for a last mission and opportunity to give Clancy Brown just like one last hurrah? I think that's a bad strategy. We're just going to go in and try and make sure nobody even gets shot at. This is our best strategy.
As far as we can tell, the aliens have figured out what's going on, and they're sending reinforcements.
Neutralize all enemy targets, secure and protect the transmitter. Wasn't this our last mission, protect the device? I'm almost positive our last mission was also, I think, a guerrilla op, wasn't it? And also, did we didn't literally sit around for an entire month. Alright, well, we're gonna have enough intel, so it doesn't matter. We're going to Advent Patrol 16 on the outskirts of Toronto. Up my homies in the APZ-16. Throw up those gang signs, yo. APZ-16, World Strait, 23rd, AP-12Z-16. I'm just yelling letters. Could be calling plays for a football game or something. APZ-16. Gangsta. Old school, baby. Alright, so we are concealed. Man, look at the sweet central air on this house. That looks like a powerful air conditioning plant right there. It's got like an iridium green glow. This is the most well climate controlled house in existence, but it's no wonder the AC's glowing iridium green. It's trying to cool the whole outdoors. There's a giant hole in the house. How do we want to approach this? All right, where's our thing? Let's see how far we are from the target. Relatively far, and there's a street with basically no cover. I don't like this. All right, Dizzy, you're taking firsties because you can grapple up to that rooftop and get yourself in a good position. Any enemies? No enemies sighted. All right, Dizzy. Fling. Also, girl, you know what I want to hear, girl. You know what I want to hear. I want to hear you say, throwing the hook.
Deploying grapple.
It's close. Deploying grapple. It's not quite throwing the hook, but it's at least in the same neighborhood. I don't want to blow our concealment, so we're going to make sure Dizzy stays in cover. There is a tower over here, a detection tower, and also, in addition to providing opportunities for the aliens to detect us, an opportunity for Casper Van Dien to do a little hacking.
Rolling.
Let's send Abuse over in this direction, see what he can come up with. All right, none of this is a detection tile. There's a civilian right there, just standing around in the Advent Patrol Zone. You know what this chick is doing? She's out here fronting. tossing up the gang sign. She's like, APZ16, yo, in a hizzy. All right, let's not do anything insane. We don't really want to blow our camouflage. We got cover here. We do. All right, Jake Busey, okay. Just a little tiny additional move. We still have no targets on the ground. All right, Neil Patrick Harris. We want you still in cover, so let's move you to here.
Copy that.
Jake Busey, we're gonna actually, you know what? We'll have Casper Van Dien move last. Busey's already deployed. We've got eyes on a turret. Turrets are problematic because they're one of the few enemy types that NPH isn't going to be able to just sort of immediately kind of fuck around with.
I'm all over it.
We do have Casper Van Dien, of course, who can just go fuck around with it sort of at will.
Got it.
Seth Gilliam, we're just going to keep you together. Casper, I'd love for you to get vision on the turret. Yeah, this is fine. Let's do this. Casper's coming up the flank, and if we need long-range fire support, it's okay for Casper to be a little further away than the rest of the team because of his blaster launcher. And now this is a bit of a pickle. Wow, these guys are patrolling at lightning speed. They're really motivated. Also, there's an Archon. That's a lot of damage. 11? Okay, we're definitely running out of time then. We got to get over here pretty much immediately. We can't really afford to fuck around. We just don't have time. All right, so Jake Busey, can you get? Yes, almost certainly. All right, so if we bring the Buse to here, this initial pod is going to get completely vaporized by a proximity mine.
I'm on the move.
I'm 100% shockingly okay with this. All right, so Busey, you're going to do this, and these guys will just be this. This is going to wipe them out. It's also going to destroy this tower. Which, you know what? Let's see what the hacking bonus is before we wreck it. If we have a really good chance of doing it... you know what? What's our hack percentage like on the turret? All right, well, first off, let's see what this is. Let's see what the bonus is. If it's something amazing, we might hack it. If it's nothing amazing, we'll just say to hell with it, and it gets, you know, exploded. We do our patented destroy everything method. We salt the earth. Facility lead. Squad recovers all action points already spent. That's actually pretty good. Is that good enough? Oh man, I'm really torn here. I'm feeling like Meryl Streep and Sophie's Choice here. Which one of my kids lives or dies? I mean, Meryl Streep could just flip a coin because arguably she should have loved them both the same. She can only save one. She might as well just say, eh, well, fuck it, let chance decide. Alright, I'm gonna blow it up. When in doubt, Pete, go for destruction. Also, is there an ashtray full of cigarettes on that rock next to Jake Busey? That's some fucking dedicated smoking right there. You'd be like, man, I keep ashtrays. There is an ashtray. Look at this. There is an ashtray full of cigarettes on that rock. That's an unusual thing to keep on a rock, I suppose. All right, Amy Smart, if we bring you up here... Trying to figure out who best to pop this pod with. Actually, I think it's Dizzy. Will you be able to see those guys from here, Dizzy? Absolutely. Is there a way we can... Oh, I was going to say we could shadow and ghost through the wall, but honestly, we don't actually need to do that. We just have Dizzy move and take advantage of her concealment. There we go. This is good. All right. We could lightning hands. I think that's the right way to start this show. So give me the lightning hands. Actually, lightning handsing the super heavy turret. Yeah, you know what? That thing's not going anywhere. We can pistol it later, too. Who has the most health? Shield bearer, elite lancer. So the elite officer has the most health and is the one we're most likely to hit. He's getting shot, then. 3 damage for you. Now the proximity mine goes off and this entire area becomes an absolute, utter whirlwind of destruction. Yeah, just casually stroll along. Don't mind that I was gonna say, why did that not go off? Turns out that guy got just completely fucking vaporized. What's left of his little friends here are in for a not great day. Man, proximity mines are so good. They are so good. All right, we need this pistol shot at the super heavy turret, Diz. This is fine. If nothing else, this lowers attacking. We might hijack that turret with Casper Van Dien if we have a reasonable chance to do so, and nothing better to do with Casper Van Dien's time. This shield bearer is a bit of a problem, though, isn't he? No, because he has 4 health and Neil Patrick Harris can kill that guy whenever the hell he wants. So no, he's not a problem at all, actually. What about this guy? Are you a problem? Maybe a minor problem. Do you have somebody who could take care of that? Seth Gilliam? I mean, Casper Van Dien could definitely kill him. What's your chance like to hack the turret here, Casper? Let's take a look at it. Looks useful, super heavy turret. Also, there's an achievement for killing something with a turret, and I don't think we have that achievement. So our hacking chances are never going to get better than this. This is as good as they're going to get. 100% to shut it down, 68%. You know what? Let's try it. For once, could you not let me down, Casper? You fucked it. I hate you so much, Casper Van Dien. Every single fucking time, man. Every single fucking time. I hate you so much, Casper. I hate you so much. Alright, well, somebody's got to do some damage to this shield bearer, then. We do not have any particular options.
I'm on it.
Or we're going to have Amy Smart take whatever her best shot is. And you're like, oh, you can just saturation fire and get the guarantee. That's true, but it takes a lot of ammo, and I don't necessarily want to do that. 89% at this guy. I am comfortable Amy Smart will be able to get this done. Great shot, Amy. Nice work. That's solid planning. What's he crouching behind? A picnic table. Sure. Okay. No, I mean, those picnic tables are noted for being dense cover. In a firefight, you always want to make sure you run behind the nearest available fucking picnic table.
I'm going.
See, even Seth Gilliam's pissed off. He's like, I should not be forced to do this. I should not be here right now. I should not be doing this. Amy Smart, why am I cleaning up your mess? And cleaning up your mess is exactly what Seth Gilliam did do. And he got that shit is clean now.
Okay, so I got one.
It's fun. Well, geez, Seth Gilliam, what's that all about? We're going to get shot by a turret. Because Amy Smart sucks. I mean, we have to kill it. Well, the other thing we could do... All right, let's do that. Now it'll kill him. I was going to say we could try and throw an insanity at the guy, but actually insanity will straight up kill him. So we kind of can't do that. We could toss a mimic beacon. I mean, there's that. We have literally no one else. All right, just soul fire the man and kill him then. I'll take the guaranteed damage. This is a dead shield bearer. We're going to get shot at by one turret who has an enhanced aim thanks to Casper Van Dien. And we've got a bunch of troopers in half cover as well. So fantastic.
Okay, so I got one.
Yeah, you got one, all right. Jake Busey, we need you in full cover and arguably like the guy to beat.
On the move.
Let's bring you up here. I have no idea how much extra defense this turret's going to get as a result of Casper's failure. Oh, it has a friend. Well, that's delightful. Meanwhile, the arc... What are we... We're going to get like 3 turns before this thing is destroyed. Those archons are doing just catastrophic damage. Jake Busey stays strong because he's untouchable. So does that mean the first one actually did kill? I mean, Jake Busey did go untouchable because he killed a guy, which is why we took him forward. That one missed because it does not have the enhanced hit ability. So we should be okay? All right then, good. So making sure Jake Busey was the target was in fact E in that situation. Izzy can only see a turret. You see the other one? Oh, just this one. We have other people who can kill that. And I'd really like to have Dizzy's blue screen rounds do some work on that other turret force. Not that we can hack it, so I mean, I guess it doesn't really matter. NPH, you're not going to be able to do much. Honestly, I'd kind of like to spawn those Archons and get them away from the thing. Am I going to deliberately run out there and spawn them? I think the answer is yes, I am. This is tricky. What if we... Okay. This is... slashing is the absolute last thing I want to do.
Going in for the kill.
This may sound insane, but I actually have a plan here that I think is going to be fairly effective.
Rolling
We're going to dash to here. I beg your pardon? Oh, so I keep forgetting that I had Jake Busey get rid of Shadow Step. Son of a bitch. Alright, well, we have spawned the pod, which, honestly, this is what I was hoping for. I keep forgetting I had Jake Busey get rid of Shadow Step. I did get rid of it for a reason, because I think it's kind of shitty. I'm not salty that I got rid of it, but I'm salty that I keep forgetting that I got rid of it. So Jake Busey then is going to rapid fire, and he's going to rapid fire this super heavy turret. This should kill it, because remember, we're ignoring all of its armor with our brand spanking new bullets. So 8 damage, and we should get another 8 from the second shot. Jake Busey becomes untouchable and implacable, and he's going to fall back. So far, so good. So far, the plan is working. All right, Jake Busey, we need to get you someplace relatively safe. Ideally, still within line of sight so that people shoot at you or you're untouchable. You know what? We'll have you move in a second. It's going to depend on what Neil Patrick Harris can do. NPH, how close can you get to the enemy? Oh, buddy, not close enough is the answer. What if we have Seth Gilliam move? We really only need one extra tile out of NPH. So, Gilliam, let's bring you up here. Can you see anything? Yes, you have the turret, good shot, bad shot at an Archon. Can you saturation fire and hit them both? Yeah, all right, well, let's just do that then. Also, this gives us a chance to test the whole I still set my fucking self on fire every time I do this. There we go. We missed the Archon and did not kill the turret. Fantastic. Did that give NPH enough of a dash? Nope. Ah, this is right, troubling. I was counting on a void rift here. We may have to, if I can't hit both of these Archons with the void rift, and I can't, because we're one tile short of where we need to be. God damn it. All right, we may have to stasis Jake Busey then. That may be the only play. Or, that's my mimic beacon. Dizzy, you don't have, who's carrying, Neil Patrick Harris is carrying a mimic beacon. So we could either stasis or mimic beacon. Man, I gotta stop giving Neil Patrick Harris the mimic beacon. He is definitively the wrong choice for that particular item.
Moving to position.
So we bring Amy Smart to here. Amy Smart will come back to you. Casper Van Dien, I'm so salty about
it. Seems doable.
Now shut up, Casper Van Dien. Nothing seems doable. You're a complete, abject, miserable failure, and I hate you. But you do have a blaster launcher, which goes basically the map. Can you hit both of... You can hit both of these guys and also not hit Jake Busey. Kind of a fan of that. Can you hit the Andromedon, too? We could hit both Archons pretty effectively. Yeah, drop the blaster launcher and give me both the Archons, then. This is all Casper's going to be able to do. I really like the blaster launcher visuals. It looks really pretty. Some solid damage there. I am comfortable with that. We got a battle frenzy. I still am not fully cognitive of specifically what battle frenzy does. I'm a little murky on the specifics. Somebody's going to have to kill that turret. Somebody who is not Neil Patrick Harris. Amy Smart can't fail to kill the turret. All right, just do it. When you give Amy Smart a can't-miss task, it's the one task you can be assured she will do with aplomb. She's like, can't miss? Oh, you know I got this. Amy Smart loves tasks at which she can't fail. She doesn't like to be challenged. Ah, it's not good, Amy Smart. You wanna push yourself, man. You wanna, you know... Gotta test your limits. Test your boundaries, man. Test your edges. I think we gotta throw a mimic beacon. As much as I hate... Yeah, you know what? Jake Busey is already hurt. I don't want Jake Busey winding up more hurt. Between the combination of Untouchable and Mimic Beacon, we should be okay here. So, Neil, toss this bad boy right out there. I'm very salty about you not being able to Void Rift those guys. On the plus side, we don't have to worry about the Thing taking any more damage because everybody's busy now. Dina Meyer, since everybody's going to be coming in to swing at the Mimic Beacon, we're just going to have her go in for the old kill zone here. This is a fantastic kill zone opportunity. We throw the Mimic Beacon out, we draw everybody into the kill zone, and then we kill them. That's why it's called kill zone. The Mimic Beacon kill zone. You better not shoot that thing again, you cocksucking piece of shit. You heard me, you son of a bitch. If you shoot at the thing, I'm gonna be so pissed off at you. I mean, arguably, I'm already as pissed off at you as I could possibly get, because I'm currently actively trying to murder you. Shooting at the Mimic Beacon? Alright. I'm gonna say, if he doesn't shoot at the Mimic Beacon, my salt is gonna be just furious. He did shoot at it, though. That's fine. Triggered the pod, activated the Mimic Beacon, and except for me forgetting that Jake Busey has Shadow Step, which is, it's like the fourth time I've done that, too. Civilian running out of the kill zone. They're like, I gotta get out of here, gotta dive for cover. Diving through a fucking door in dramatic fashion to try and evade the kill zone. That's pretty smart thinking. You're now in battle frenzy, which means I guess you're gonna kill our mimic beacon. Yep, you sure did. Whack. And then our other little friend should come up to take a swing at the untouchable Jake Busey. He's like the unsinkable Molly Brown, except with less ship involved. And Dizzy just straight up exec- Man, Killzone plus- You know what? Only the best. Killzone plus Executioner plus a repeater is not terrible. Because individual shots with like a 15% chance to kill the enemy are not that good. But when you couple that with like six different shots, you're adding that chance for the execution, you're adding it a bunch of different times. And that sort of becomes, I mean, that's actually a pretty strong... Yeah, the percentages on that are not as bad as I thought when you consider the fact that some units can shoot more than one time around. I mean, if you drop that on like a kill zone that's going to affect seven guys, and you have if you have enough bullets, that's seven chances for an instant kill. That's not too terrible. Grenade! 7 15% chances for an instant kill. That's going to add up in the long run. So Seth Gilliam's just getting rid of some cover for us here. He also got a critical, murdered most of that guy's armor. All of those things are good. That's going to let Jake Busey go do some real nasty shit to him. Specifically, just basically walk up and shotgun. Not too worried about this one health Archon. We've got a number of people who can destroy that man. So we're going to go for the old rapid fire. And Mr. Andromedon here is about to get shit on. Or missed. You better make this one count, Jake. Alright, you did in fact make it count. That's why you had two shots. Took you two, though, by the way. If I was John Wayne and you were Dean Martin and this was Rio Bravo right now, I'd be saying, took you two! And then you'd have to come back and say, it didn't account for the wind. Ah, Rio Bravo. Great movie. Well, Neil Patrick Harris, I'm afraid thanks to your one tile too slow action, not going to be a whole lot for you to contribute on this particular mission. I don't think you can do any insanity to a robot, can you? We'll kill this guy, though, so sure. Right? We're going to kill you with madness. We call that the old Heath Ledger tree. Aw, oh, Pete, that wasn't funny. See, you know, I feel bad about the whole Heath Ledger thing, because he was a good actor, seemed like a pretty nice guy, and he went out and drove himself crazy to play the Joker, and arguably he did a good job. I mean, he's definitely, I think, been the best Joker who has ever been committed to film, but... I mean, the guy had some problems because he thought that driving himself crazy so that he could actively play the Joker was a good idea. Which, that makes me wonder, I mean, was it the driving himself crazy that caused his inevitable doom? Or was it actually just the fact that maybe he wasn't a little unhinged in the first place? I mean, it's a chicken or egg thing, and it all worked out with his broken egg for Heath Ledger. And I would have loved to have seen what he could have done with the Joker in the future, but yeah, man, how did I get off on this? I'm off on a weird tangent. Terminated. I'm way off topic, but I also think this mission is basically over. It's somehow not over. What enemies are left? Are they not counting the turrets in the nine?
I'm going.
Even if they do count the turrets, we're one short. That's only eight, counting the turrets. There's supposed to be a ninth man. Where is the mysterious ninth man? Who is John Galt? Because despite hating Ayn Rand, I take opportunities to make references to her work at pretty much every occasion. Some civilians still running. Where is this mysterious alien? If he's still shooting at the thing, we're fucked. Why is Dina Meyer on fire? Izzy, why are you on fire? How did Izzy get set on fire? Did she set her own cover on fire? All right, I'm salty. Because now we have two people who are hurt. Somebody has a med kit. I think it's Casper Van Dien. No, it is not Casper Van Dien. Who has my med kit? Somebody's got it. It's Neil Patrick Harris. Neil, get over here and fix this. Nobody is shooting at the thing anymore, though. So, I mean, that's good.
I'm going.
Yeah, fix Dizzy. Just spit on her or something. Really seems like you shouldn't need a med kit to help put somebody out on fire. I mean, you have natural firefighting in every human body. If nothing else, they could just be on Dizzy. Just be like, sorry, Diz. I mean, I know this is sort of gross and kind of humiliating, but, I mean, I gotta use my natural flame retardant here. And, I got a full bladder. Overwatch. So where's the last guy? We want Dizzy back on a rooftop if we can get her up there. Up on a rooftop. Quick, quick, quick. Dizzy. So throw the grapple. This seems good. Again, Dizzy. Grapple. There you go. Throw the hook. She didn't say throw in the hook. So this mysterious enemy is nowhere to be found. We're going to have Dizzy reload. On the plus side, we're not on a clock anymore, so we can take as, you know, take as much time as we want. Seems like this is a good opportunity for some reloads then. Rearm, reload, refresh, regear, re-equip. I can't think of anything else that starts with a re. Just trying to push that to the absolute limit. Turns out I should have just bailed on it at the first opportunity.
Overwatch.
All right, Casper Van Dien, I guess we're just coming up here. What is this button? Open, close door. We don't, all right. So where's the enemy, by the way? Anybody? Anybody seen the bad guys? Anyone? No. Nobody can see shit. Also, we have completely annihilated any form of cover in this area, so running up through here is a really terrible idea. Scanning protocol. Find the last enemy for me, please, Casper Van Dien. They theoretically should be coming towards the thing. There are two civilians over there. Great. That's exactly what I needed to know. I'm not really worried about the two civilians. Unless they're faceless? No, because we canceled that. They can't be faceless. Where the hell are the enemies then? All right, Seth, let's have you advance to here, I guess.
Hope it's worth it.
Most of all, we want to get you away from the fucking propane tank, because I can see you and a fire and a spark and that having a tragic ending.
Moving to position.
Jake Busey, maybe you'll go see him? Bad guys? Anywhere? Nearby? Something? We got a burning house going on over here. Our house is burning down. Still no enemies. Alright, well, I guess we can just sort of willy-nilly advance then. There's, like, nothing in this area. Where the hell's the last enemy?
Running.
Seth Gilliam, you're on Overwatch, because I think they might be around that corner. Dizzy, you're also on Overwatch. Here we go. Oh, great, there's a surprise sectopod. Sure, that makes perfect sense. Did you just execute a sect... Oh, Dizzy, my beauty. Oh, my love. Oh, that was so fucking awesome. Dizzy is the greatest trooper in the history of XCOM. She one-shot killed a sectopod with a blue screen. That was absolutely fucking beautiful.
Menace 1-5, neutralize all remaining enemies and secure the AO.
Even Bradford was fucking impressed with Dizzy's performance. He's like, you know what?
Whatever information it managed to pull from the Advent Network.
What? How did it get destroyed? Did it burn? This means we're not going to get the intel, doesn't it? So we had a catastrophic triumph, and then this happened because of reasons, I guess. We didn't set this fire either, I'd like to point out. I'm calling a Billy Joel here. We didn't start this fire. It was always burning since the world's been turning. The enemies actually started that fire. If we don't get the intel for completing this mission, I'm going to be unspeakably salty. All right, Neil Patrick Harris, just end this fucking mockery of a mission.
The rift beckons.
I'm very, very pissed off now. These guys are dead. That's the end of the mission. One turn too late to save that from randomly exploding, because that's the most sensible shit ever all time. It wasn't even taking damage from fire or anything either. Yeah, mission failed. Rating poor. Operation Vengeful Death should have been called Operation Total Fucking Bullshit. I'm very salty about the way that one turned out, and we are not going to get the intel for that. Don't hang your heads, guys. We got screwed. We were robbed, all y'all. Don't feel bad at all. We got dicked hardcore on this one. We got hardcore fucked. And also now we have what? Like, something bad is going to happen to us too. I'm supremely pissed off. This is not how I planned to go into the enemy facility. I wanted to go in with every single bonus, and now it looks like we're going to go in with one, maybe two bonuses. Very, very salty. I'm not happy. Not happy at all. Look, don't hang your head in shame, Dizzy. You get your head up, girl. You be proud of what you did. You one-shot killed a sectopod. That's a fucking remarkable feat, Dizzy. Don't you even dare. This is not the morale the team needed going into the mission. This is not what we needed. This is very bad for morale. Going into our final mission and we get screwed by some gamey stupid bullshit because one of the plasma shots from an Archon set the object on fire. Those things should not be burnable. And Dizzy and Jake are wounded. Very upset. So superior repeater, a PCS advanced mobility, plus one speed, blah, blah, blah. We got some stuff. Yes, we, fine, whatever. I don't, we can break down a sectopod too. Operation Vengeful Death has got me very upset. One thing I am going to do before I forget then, we will have Dr. Tygen complete his quest to cream the 16. I think a sectopod may be the only thing we have not investigated. We're going to give him a chance. This was his goal. Every single possible alien that can be humped must be humped. He's going to do this. We're going to give this to Dr. Tygen. We owe it to him.
We can see that is not the case. Not unlike the mechanized Advent units, which were likely derived from the sectopod itself.
Uh-huh.
This machine seems to be entirely autonomous.
Okay. Well, they've been entirely ineffective. That's what they've been, Dr. Tygen. Also, it doesn't really seem like you're going to have a whole lot of difficulty finding a place to hump that. I mean, that one's big enough you could just crawl inside it like a wampa.
If we disrupt the Advent dampening field and their network in the process, we stand a reasonable chance of toppling the aliens' grip on our world.
Ooh-ha.
Thought had never occurred to me that I might actually live to see this day.
Really, Dr. Tygen? You honestly thought you would expire before I got shit done? You should have known from the moment you pulled that chip out of my head that everything was going to be okay, Dr. Tygen. Perfidious P is here now. I got you, boo. I got you. I've also got this one wrapped up. If you enjoyed the episode, feel free to drop a like down in the comment section. Of course, your support does really mean a lot to us. And if you'd like to get us, get screwed by gamey bullshit flaming objects that were destroyed despite having a remarkable health total, I consider subscribing as well, because I don't know, it's probably not going to happen again. I say that like it's something that occurs regularly, but I mean, it's probably not going to happen. Anyway, thanks very much for watching. I'll see you again soon, probably to assault the alien facility.